Hello everyone, happy Monday and happy holiday too, and happy new year. Yes, it's already, today's the 20, it's just like, time just fly, I can't believe it's already 20 days that we are, and 2020 is a new decade, a new year, right? I've been rehearsing and thinking about this video now, you know, since of the beginning of the year. And I was just trying just to get myself in a better place so I could come here. As you saw the topic, right? New year, new goal, new resolutions, new you, right? That's how we feel like at the end of the year, right? And it, sometimes it can get very overwhelmed, right? But when we are trying just to put together, you know, our new goals for the new upcoming year, in this case was not only the year, but also, you know, a new decade, no pressure, 2020. How about our spiritual goals for 2020? And how can we infuse, you know, our day with intention and awareness in 2020? And I'm gonna tell why I decided just to do this video and why I waited until today, the 20 days after New Year's to do that, why I didn't do it December 31st, why I didn't do it the first week of January. 2019 for me is a year that if you ask me, Keula, can you describe 2019 in only one word? I'll pick the word breakthrough, and then I'll explain why I'll pick the word breakthrough. You know, 2019 was a year of change for me, a lot of change. In the year that, you know, I was growing as a person, I was evolving, and, you know, I was in a pain. I went through so much in 2019. I share sometimes here with you how I felt, you know, with some situations that I was dealing at the time. But to be honest with you, it all the pain that I was experiencing in 2019, it brought me close to God, brought me close to my spiritual goals. When I started 2019, I have all my New Year resolution for 2019. And I have to tell you, I have no spiritual goals at all. So what happened in my life, you know, the struggles, the storms, the challenge. And then I faced that I had to hold it something stronger, bigger than me, right? In my case, I'm a God believer. All the challenges and all the storm and all the things I was facing bring me closer to God. At the time, you know, I did not set an intention, you know, in the beginning of the year that, yes, I'm going to start my day and I want to build a closer relationship with God. Didn't happen this way. You know, it just was the circumstance, you know, the pain, the issues that I was dealing at the time. It really brought me closer to God. Now, if I have to pick one word to describe my year, I would say breakthrough, because I made it. Yeah, I made it to God, because God gave me strength every day. And I, to be honest with you, I have days that I even could not get up off the bed. I have just to look for strength in Lord and, you know, do my worship. And I had my Bible study. So I created support with a good friends, the support system. So we had the Bible study every other week. And that made me strong. So with that being said, it was a big challenge. It was a big change in my life, and I'm grateful for, right? I'm grateful for the challenge. I'm grateful for the storm, for the struggles, because it made me who I am. I came out of 2019 as a better person, as a better human being, and I love that. So that's why now when I was thinking about 2020, new year, new goals, new resolution, and then I thought, like, how about I start different? But I want to start my 2020 as my spiritual goals on the first number one in my New Year resolution list. And I felt like it was so important to have as a priority. It's very important we take care, you know, our mental, you know, health, our soul. You know, we worry a lot about different things, right? We have to make money. We have just to, so much other stuff is easy just to, you know, to get lost. As I was doing this this exercise last week just to share this with our ladies on the Bible study, I thought it was important for me to come here and share with you this too. So this is a kind like, you know, new year, you know, unresolution, right? Why is unresolution? We think about resolution, right? It just like, because resolution, we want to get all done, right? We have that big list, we want to get all done. But this exercise that we did in our Bible study last week was exactly like, you know, do less, but be focused and commit with that thing that you want to do it, right? How you can set intention and awareness infuse every day in your life, right? So first, number one thing, okay? The number one, write this down. The term, the kind of person you want to become in 2020. I'm sure we all have in the back of the mind who we want to be. Oh, Keula, how come? You know, I know who I am. I don't know. I don't need to become. Of course, you know, if you think that you already hit the ceiling and then you cannot go anywhere, you have to understand that we are a work in progress in God's hands. So every day He's shaping us. Think about the flower, right? The flower doesn't come out of like a flower with the petals. No, you know, they form, you know, and that's the same like us. We grow, we evolve. So think about what kind person you want to become in 2020, right? And then maybe you can go back and think about who you have been in the past, in previous years, in 2019, in 2018, 2017. Priority change, life change, right? So, you know, funny and different to watch me, right? And I can't imagine when you watching me, because I shared the most of my change here with you all, right? Even for me, sometimes it was hard for me to see it. Wow, I would not do this a year ago like this, you know? I'll react different for this situation. You know, change are kind of weird, but they are good. So the number one, determine the kind of person you want to become in 2020. Right. The number two, identify, you know, the characteristic of that person. You know, is that person nice? Is that person calm? Is that person focused? And then that is the fun part of this exercise that I love it when we did with our ladies in our Bible study, was just to pick the word. Because again, it's easy, okay? Especially in the beginning of the year, right? We have that long New Year resolution that we want to do all, right? We want to do a lot of change. Of course, it's a new year, new decade. We have a blank canvas right in our face and we can draw whatever we want, right? And it's true. But you know, along the way, we can get distracted and we can lose our focus. So that's why, instead just to pick so much stuff, so many words, you just pick one word that you can stick all year long with that word and they be focused. To give you some example, you know, like last year, like I said, I did not have any spiritual goals, but actually through the pain that I was living at the time, for the storms and the struggles, you know, I came very spiritual, very close to God, and this was just a blessing for me, but I didn't plan that. So that's why I thought that 2020, I do want to have start the year with spiritual goals. And I remember, you know, when I was going to the struggles, I had a word that I kept in my mind. And the word that I had in the back of my mind that helped me a lot in 2019 was the word victory. Victory, yes. Even there is a song that I love to play. It's a worship song that's, you know, the victory. You have your victory, right? And I was just taking possession of my victory. And I even got this ring, you can see, let me show you here, with a V sign. And then every time, and I fell down, that I felt that the enemy wanted to put me down, I just like, you know, I put my fist like that, and I just say like, Back off. You have no rights in my life. Here's my V of victory, and I got this, you know, and in the name of Jesus. And this reminds me all year long that, you know, yes, I was going through tough times. I was in pain. I was having difficult time, but I knew that the victory was coming. And that's why I called that my word for 2019 was the breakthrough, right? In the end of the year. And victory, I carry victory, you know, with me all year long. And since that V of victory was so important for me last year, I thought in 2020, you know, that's gonna be again my inspiration word. So my message here for you, with all those words that you saw that I listed here on the top of the video about, you know, who you want to become, you know, in 2020. You want to be more brave. You want to surrender. You want to find balance in your life, contentment, peace, be more bold, right? Fearless, right? Sometimes we get so much fear with us. You want to have more faith. You want to be more grateful, have more hope, discipline, you know, release, freedom, you know, whatever word. When you look, those words that I put on the top, pick only one. And make sure to share that word. Not only write that word in big print letters, bold, and put it like in a place that you can see all the time, right? But also tell your best friends, you know, that's gonna keep you, you know, reliable. You know, that's the person I want to become in 2020. Folks, listen. It's not easy. I'm telling you, life sometimes can be hard. Things can happen and unexpected things. I'm telling you because I've been waiting, you know, for like 20 days to be here just to be ready to do this video for you because I need to find a time that I was feeling good. Because when I come here, I gotta, you know, I always myself. I don't want just to deliver a message that I don't feel the message. Well, since November, it was like, you know, November 20, I've been feeling very down and depressed. I don't like the cold weather. It really affects me emotionally as well. So, you know, November, December, I've been a little depressed. And listen, I still get things done, okay? But it takes me, you know, it's 10 times harder. You know, I still get up off the bed. I still do my things. I still, you know, do my event. That's why I waited until today. Because I say, I can't wait until, you know, February is here. Then it's not going to be New Year anymore. I have to do this video. So I prepare myself emotionally. And I thought it was important for me to come here and share this message with you. Because it's still time. You know, if you already have your New Year resolution for 2020, so it's time just to do the unresolution instead to do get to try to get all those things done that you have in your list. Just pick only one word from, you know, the list that I put above in my video, or maybe choose your own word, right? Because victory wasn't there when I chose those words. So I add my word victory that I'm going to stick with 2020. Change is just like, you know, sometimes it takes time. It's step by step, right? Sometimes we just feel like, oh, I want to make a change. We want to be rewarded right away, you know? It thinks that life is not like that. That's why sometimes we get impatient and that we take baby steps. When I started to do the Bible study, I was doing once a month, and then, you know, we decided to do every other week. So, you know, I started baby steps. My changes and my goals, and I'm talking about my spiritual goals. I even had times that I felt like, okay, I had to cancel the Bible study. And I couldn't. I felt bad, even if I wasn't feeling okay, if I had too much going on at the time. But I felt bad for the other ladies that was also counting with the Bible study. It's been such a blessing, you know. Set goals, or make changes slowly, baby steps. So, you know, when you have other people, you share with other people, they help you to keep you accountable, right? And I felt like the ladies on the Bible study helped me to keep myself accountable through the year. The other things to help you to become more spiritual in 2020, empowerment, retreatment for women, you know, and that's important. It's just like, folks, you know, life gets so busy. Sometimes we have just to take a deep breath and look around us and go outside and see the, watch the nature, you know, see the rain, you know, and hear the rain. Those type of stuff that when we get overwhelmed with our issues and the storms, the challenges, the struggles that come through everyday life, we can just take our focus away. Focus on your spiritual goals for 2020. Because I can promise you, if it wasn't for me building a closer relationship to God, that I'm saying that, you know, I'm a godly woman, but whatever religion that you are, for your, you know, strong power that you believe, I could not have made it 2019. That's my point here for you, right? We have to invest in our soul, in our mental health. We have to feed our soul. If you have a healthy body but unhealthy soul, you know, we're not gonna go far, you know, with our financial goals or other, you know, relationship goals. Your soul is the foundation of everything. My soul is not right, you know, nothing's right with me. My business not right, my relationship with my husband's not right, with my kids not right, you know, everything, it just fell apart. I need to definitely have my spiritual goals as the first number one of my New Year resolution. All the things that we can do, like, you know, the practice of the spiritual takeaways, you know. Listen, I'm there too, okay? We always talk about, you know, sometimes, you know, forgiveness, right? Read the Bible, or just we post all those beautiful quotes here. That. Have you thinking about the people that the grounds that we hold? I feel like I do hold grounds, and it's something that, you know, definitely I'm gonna pray to God just to bless me in this year, in 2020, that I can release all this grudge, you know, that I have in my heart, because this is for me, it's not good to others, but it's not first good for me. So read the Bible, you know, we're talking about forgiveness, always think about, like, you know, the grudge that we keep against others, and that's something definitely I have to work on me this year. I did practice the presence of God all year long and helped me, you know, so much. And then I'm gonna tell how in times that I felt weak, that I even could not pray, you know, I just, like, we have this thing about God, right, that we think that God is there, that he can hear us, or just, like, we feel guilty because we did something that we think that's not so good, and God is upset with us, so we don't communicate, we don't talk to God. But I set a point that I wake up every morning, you know, and with my worship songs, even though I didn't feel well, the worship start to change, you know, my mood, you know, my heart. If I wake up and I was depressed, if I didn't feel well, but as I was listening to worship, God, is that those words, remember what you feed your soul, right? Listen, don't take me wrong, I love hip hops, I love any kind songs, and I play a lot, but I stopped a lot through 2019 to play those crazy songs with, you know, bad lyrics. I still do, by the way. I play because I enjoy sometimes, but I set an intention. That's the change, the things that changed in 2019 in my life. I set intention. So every time when I get up in the morning, I play my worship songs, because I realize that having those beautiful lyrics, you know, speaking to me, it helps me, you know, it feeds my soul, it helps me, you know, to go through my day. And even I hold my phone all day long, carry around the house, whatever, I go play my worship song when I was in my car. It helped me, folks. So it's just a little tip for you. It was a life change for me, because sometimes when we are in a dark spot, when we are not feeling 100% with ourselves, we have hard time to talk to God, you know? And, you know, I have those times that I even cannot pray, I even can't talk to God. But we have to understand that God is someone, you know, that you can talk like you talk to your friend, and you gotta come to him as you are, right? When I wasn't good, I come to him and I say, I'm not good, you know? What else can I say? You know me better than anybody. The thing is, affirmations. It's so important for us to be kind, and, you know, our thoughts go 1,000 miles an hour, and we think so much, a lot of different things all the time. I saw myself like that, like in November. I was such in a good speed, you know, in 2019 with my spiritual goals and doing my stuff and not letting put me down with, you know, the challenge I was facing. And then in November 20, you know, when I lost my friend and, you know, all the things happened, it really knocked me down. And I saw myself in a situation that I was depressed. I was having, you know, bad thoughts, a lot of fear, you know, and just, but affirmations, folks, you know, we have to be focused, you know, and always have word of affirmation. I may have been having this challenge today, but, you know, tomorrow gonna be a better day.
Power of choice,
you know, life also is made of choice. Set intentions, you know, for to become a better you in 2020. Life is made of choice. Again, I mentioned about the rose. The rose, it start only with a little bud, right? And then it just like the petals come, they transform, they evolve, they grow, right? That's us. And I was talking to my sister about this. So my sister always have passion for cars. So she always liked to have, you know, fancy cars and, you know, imported cars. Like a year ago, I think she sold her car. She wants just to invest in her business and she sold her car and she was without car for a while. And then finally her husband got her a new car. Wasn't a fancy one, was a brand new one, but was a car that was going to take her to places to help her because she has two kids. And she was so happy. She was just telling me, say, Keula, you know, it's so funny. This is a new car, but it's not the most fancy and expensive car. But I just see now that I have two kids, 4 years old, and I had a 2 years old, how priority changes. Cars is not my priority anymore. I can go as I want, and I have some a car to take me to places. You know, I don't care if it's not the most expensive car. So that's the thing, folks. I'm telling you, you know, the power of choice. Every day in life, we have choices, right? I am in a different place today that I was last year, that I was a year before. That's why I can't wait to see, you know, the person that I'll become in 2020. Because I probably gonna not gonna be this Keula that's talking to you right now. And that's the beauty, you know, about the transformation, about going through struggles, right? And challenge. Because when life is too perfect for us, we are in our little, you know, comfort zone. We don't grow. We stay stagnant, right? Why to change? Everything is too good. It's now, let's keep the same. But when things doesn't go the way we plan it, then we are forced, you know, to move, to make change. That's the time that we grow the most. Like, you know, I'm so grateful for all the pain that I had to go through in 2019. If it wasn't for the pain, if it wasn't for the people that create the pain of the situations, of the struggles, I wasn't where I stand today. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, the power of choice. We can choose just to be upset of the situation, you know, and feeling sorry and just say, why me, why me, why me? Or we can just take that situation, you know, and use as, you know, motivation to make you a better person, to make the better you for 2020. It's important that we always begin our day and end our day with some quiet moment of reflection. And sometimes we don't realize how blessed we are. And, you know, when we get up every morning, right? Because, you know, life is fragile. You know, you're here, and at any moment, we could not be here anymore. It's how things it is. And I have put a lot of thoughts on this, you know, since the end of the year, because I realized that, you know, life is way too fragile. You know, at any moment, at any time, you know, God can tell you, hello, Keula, it's your turn. It's time to come back home, and it's over. Your time there is over. Nothing can be done anymore, right? And then we run. Sometimes we don't stop, right? And then we forget about, you know, how about if today is my last day? Gratitude in your heart and thanking God for one more day, right? And noticing a wonder, like simple things, like I said, you know, with social media today, it's just like we get so distracted commenting our friends' lifestyle, right? And we forgot just to notice and wonder, notice the little things in life. Is a, you know, if it's a rainy day, it's a sunny day, the beautiful of a bird singing outside of the house, the snow day, right? Those are the little things. It just help us, you know, to be focused. And then and expand self-acceptance. You know, nobody's perfect, folks. You know, this is my last thing here for you. You know, sometimes people say like, oh, you know, I don't feel like I can build this relationship with God because I'm very imperfect. We all are, you know, we all are. But the thing is, you know, we have to accept ourselves first. I'm not saying that not live in denial, okay? It's important to understand your weakness and your strengths, things that you have to get better, right? And as specific, yeah, God, just, you know, the things that he had to work on you, right? I want to become actually more loving and more calm. I have, you know, very short temper. I can get, you know, angry easy. I've been asking God, and I've been praying, I asking the ladies, you know, Bible study, to help me to pray to God, can make me more calm, more loving. Tell me my anger. That's the word. But at the same time, I know that I have good intentions. I know that I want to improve. I want to grow. I want to evolve as a person. And I'm not gonna let, you know, my imperfection, you know, keep me away from the things that God had reserved for me. Remember my victories. That's why I don't let the enemy tell me lies, right? I confront the enemy all the time. And then he may tell me, Keula, you're not good enough. And I say, maybe I'm not good enough for you, but I am good enough for God. You know, because remember, God loves us not because we are good. He loves us because he is good. Isn't that wonderful? We know that. But when I look back in 2019, you know, I have to say that I'm grateful, and please don't take me wrong. It was a very difficult year for me, but I learned a lot of things. I learned like nobody but God fight your battles, even your own husband, even your wife, even your friends. Nobody gonna fight your battles but God. That's what I learned. I learned also in 2019 with all my struggles and all the challenges that I don't need approval from anybody. The only approval that I need is from God. That's it. And I also learned that the devil had no power in my life. The enemy had no power. And I have to tell him so many times, back off. You have no rights in my life. And that's the tip that I give it to you today. Always say, in name of Jesus, back off. You don't have power in my life. He will back off, I promise. You know, he got intimidated. Yeah. So, folks, that's the message for today. Healthy mind, you know, healthy body, healthy everything. The new goal, new resolutions, new you. Set your spiritual goal. If you're not a God believer, but if you have all the beliefs, you know, holding the strong power bigger than you. And then that's gonna help you a lot. Don't forget, just to look those words that I put here on the video and pick a word that you're gonna stick to the year. I know you're gonna be tempted to pick 3, 4, 5 words, okay? But don't do that, please. And I challenge you. So write that down, that word that you chose for you, the person that you want to become in 2020. So my word is victory for myself and victory for you too, but pick your own word. And don't be tempted to pick 2 or 3 or 4, okay? Be focused. Focus here. Just remember, you know, it's hard to get different results doing the same things over and over, right? If you want a new year, new goal, a new you, you just like do different things in different ways because you're not gonna get different results doing the same thing over and over. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. I have a lot to share here with you, the things that I'm thinking about, how I'm gonna use social media in 2020 just to we can, you know, keep in power each other, supporting each other. And for now, just remember, be you, do you, and stay true, and let me know what kind person you want to become in 2020 and live the world right now. If you like this video, make sure just to give me a like. I'll talk to you later, folks. Bye bye. Love you all.